This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
This problem is about a horizontal elastic pendulum in simple harmonic motion. So in this video, we are going to determine the mechanical energy of the oscillator Earth system, determine the differential equation that governs the variation of x, and then verify the solution to this equation, determine the initial phase angle of oscillations, and finally, determine the instance at which g reaches O.
Consider this horizontal elastic pendulum. The force constant of the spring is 10 newtons per meter, and the mass of the block is 0.5 kilograms. The block of center of mass g is displaced horizontally to the right by a distance of 10 centimeters, and then it is released from rest at t0 equals 0. So the initial conditions at t0 equals 0, x0 is positive since the block is displaced in the positive x direction to the right. So it is 10 centimeters divided by 100, which becomes 0.1 meters. The block is released from rest, so the initial speed is 0. We neglect all friction. Take the horizontal plane containing the center of mass g of the block as a reference level for a gravitational potential energy. At equilibrium, g coincides with the origin O of the x-axis as shown on the figure. Part 1. Calculate the mechanical energy of the system S, which is the block, the spring, and the earth at t0 equals 0. The expression of ME is ME is equal to KE plus GPE plus EPE. You know that KE 0 is equal to 0 since the block is released from rest, and the gravitational potential energy is 0 because G is at the reference level of gravitational potential energy. So we still have the elastic potential energy, 1 half KX 0 squared. So K is 10 newtons per meter and X 0 is 0.1 meters. The answer is 0.05 joules. Part 2. A. Write the expression of ME of the system S in terms of X, V, and K. In general, ME is equal to KE plus GPE plus EPE in this course. But because GPE is always 0, because G is always at the reference level of gravitational potential energy, so we still have ME is equal to KE, which is 1 half mv squared, plus EPE, which is 1 half kx squared.
2b. Deduce the differential equation that governs the variation of x. Since friction is negligible, or the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is 0, then the mechanical energy is conserved. So, the expression of the mechanical energy, which is 1 half mv squared plus 1 half kx squared, is equal to constant. Then differentiate both sides. So dme by dt is equal to 0 since the mechanical energy is constant. So the derivative of 1 half mv squared is equal to 1 half m to vv prime, and the derivative of 1 half kx squared is equal to 1 half k to xx prime. 2 times half is equal to 1. So we get mv v prime plus kx x prime is equal to 0. As you know, x prime is equal to v, and v prime is equal to x double prime. And now take v as a common factor, we get a new relation, which is v into mx double prime plus kx is equal to 0. Now we have two solutions. V is equal to 0, or mx double prime plus kx is equal to 0. But v is equal to 0 is a solution is rejected, because if v equal to 0, we have no motion. But this is not the case. So the acceptable solution is mx double prime plus kx is equal to 0. Divide by m both sides, we get the second order differential equation, which is x double prime plus k over mx is equal to 0.
Part 2c, deduce the nature of the motion of a g. So this is the obtained differential equation. This differential equation is of the form x double prime plus omega naught squared x equal 0, with omega naught squared equal k over m being a positive constant. So the nature of the motion of the block is simple harmonic. 3. Indicate the type of oscillations of g. These oscillations are free because we don't have external intervention and we don't have a friction also. So the type is free undamped mechanical oscillations.
Focus, please. This is important.
Question 4a. Verify that x equal xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi is a solution of the differential equation, where xm and phi are constant and omega 0 is equal to the square root of k over m. And then deduce the value of the natural or the proper period of oscillation. X is equal to xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Xm is constant and cosine omega 0 t plus phi is variable. The derivative of cosine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to minus omega 0 sine omega 0 t plus phi. Then x prime is equal to minus omega 0 xm sine omega 0 t plus phi. Now the second derivative of x, minus omega 0 xm is constant and sine omega 0 t plus phi is variable. The derivative of sine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to plus omega 0 cosine omega 0 t plus phi. So x double prime is given by minus omega 0 squared xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Comparing xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi to x, we can conclude that xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi is equal to x. Now we have found a relation between x double prime and x such that x double prime is equal to minus omega 0 squared x. Using this differential equation, replace x or x double prime in its expression by minus omega 0 squared x in this differential equation. As you see, minus omega 0 squared is equal to x double prime. So minus omega 0 squared x plus k over mx is equal to 0. But omega 0 squared is equal to k over m. Now replace k over m by omega 0 squared. We get a new relation, which is minus omega 0 squared x plus omega 0 squared x is equal to 0. Since 0 equals 0, therefore x equal xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi is the solution, or is a solution of the differential equation. Now, the natural period is given by this formula, 2 pi over omega 0. But omega 0 equal the square root of k over m, so t0 is equal to 2 pi the square root of m over k. Now substitute for m equals 0.5 kg and k equals 10 newtons per meter. The final result of t0 is equal to 1.4 seconds.
Now let's move to part 4b, determine the values of xm and phi. You know that the values of xm and phi are determined from the initial conditions x0 and v0. First, let's remember the initial conditions in this question. At t0 equals 0, we have x is equal to x0, which is equal to 0.1 meter, and v0 equals 0. And the time equation of our oscillator is x equal xm cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Now replace x by 0.1 meters and t by 0. This is going to be x0 is equal to 0.1 meters, which is equal to xm cosine phi, because omega 0 t now is 0. So this is equation 1, in which we have xm is unknown and cosine phi is also unknown. Let's move to the expression of v. V is equal to x prime, which is equal to minus xm omega 0 sine omega 0 t plus phi. Similarly, we will replace v by 0 and t by 0. This is going to be v0 is equal to 0, which is equal to minus xm omega 0 sine phi. Now, look at this equation. Xm omega 0 is different from 0. So we still have sine phi is equal to 0. Now, if sine phi is equal to 0, then you can get the first value from the calculator, so phi is equal to 0, and the second value can be obtained from this math relation. Sine phi is equal to sine phi minus phi. So the first value is 0 and the second value is pi minus 0, which is equal to pi. Now, which one of these two values we must choose in our question? Let's see. Go back to equation 1. In equation 1, xm is positive, and here we have plus 0.1, so cosine phi is positive. Now, one of these angles has a positive cosine, and it will be our angle. Cosine phi is negative, so phi is not our choice. Cosine 0 is plus 1, which is positive, so the 0 is the chosen angle. To calculate xm, we move again to equation 1. Xm is equal to 0.1 over cosine phi, which is equal to 0.1 over cosine 0, and the answer is 0.1 meters.
Part 4c. Use the time equation to determine in terms of the natural period t0 the instant at which g reaches O. During oscillation, G passes through O at many instants. The question is to determine the values of these instants in terms of T0. The time equation is X equal XM cosine omega 0 T. At the equilibrium or at the origin, X is equal to 0. Now, substitute for X equal to 0 in this equation, we get 0 equal XM cosine omega 0 T. But XM cannot be 0, then cosine omega 0 t is equal to 0. In general, when alpha or when cosine alpha is equal to 0, then alpha has the form of 2k plus 1 pi over 2, where k belongs to z, or k equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, etc. So, by assuming that omega 0 t is equal to alpha, then we can write omega 0 t equal to k plus 1 pi over 2. But k now belongs to n since t is greater than or equal to 0. But the question to determine t in terms of the natural period t0. So omega 0 is replaced by 2 pi over t0. Now, by substituting omega 0 by 2 pi over 2 over t0, we get a new relation among t, t0, and k, which is 2 pi t over t0 is equal to 2k plus 1 pi over 2. Divide by pi both sides and do the cross product. So the expression of t when the block reaches O is given by 2k plus 1 t0 over 4, where k belongs to n. Now, to determine the first instant, just substitute for k equals 0. So the first instant when g reaches O is equal to t0 over 4. To determine the second instant, just substitute for k equal 1. So the second instant is equal to 3 t0 over 4, and so on.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.